I start out, and I've hauled, like I said, I've hauled them in at noon. And Michigan coyotes aren't that vocal, okay? But they will talk back to you, and that's when the fun really starts. And I've noticed, I've been howling for a number of years, I've noticed that because the population is increasing, the coyotes are becoming more and more territorial. They're starting to bump into each other. So I've noticed that the howling, responses from howling has been going up each year. And like I said, I really think that's because the population is going up. And the way I start my stands out, so I've hauled them in the middle of the day. I've had them answer back in the middle of the day. Very often? No, a couple times probably. You know, it's usually early morning or in the evening that I like to hunt. But this is what I do. Let that taper off like that, and then I'll wait. There's no set rule, okay? I'll wait maybe 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes. I don't know. I've had success waiting a minute. I've had success waiting 5 minutes. And then I'll usually go into some distress calling. I'm not a quiet caller at all, okay? When I do my distress, most people would describe it as extreme volume, okay? Now, one time, this was a number of years ago, I took my brother out on his first predator hunt ever. He had hunted deer and all the, you know, turkey, all that stuff, never coyotes or fox. The area that we were going to hunt, I knew there were fox in that area too. Fox and coyotes don't like each other. Usually if you're in an area where there's a lot of fox, there's no coyotes. If there's a lot of coyotes, there's no fox. Gray fox can do a little bit better because they can climb a tree. Red fox can't do that. So if I think there's a fox or an opportunity to maybe call a fox in, I won't howl, okay, because that'll scare him away. So we go out. This is his first predator hunt ever, and I get him set up about 30, 40 yards just on the other side of a little hill, and I start out with my rabbit distress. Do it for, you know, a minute or so and then stop. And 30 seconds after I stopped, he starts. Well, first of all, I didn't know he even had a call, okay? So I'm sitting there, and he's just, I mean, wailing and wailing and wailing. I'm thinking, is he ever going to stop? He keeps calling and screaming and wailing away, and I'm thinking, now I'm getting mad because I'm doing the calling. This went on for about 3 or 4 minutes, and finally it stops. I'm thinking, oh, good, finally he stopped, you know? And then 30 seconds later, he starts back up again. Just screaming and wailing, and you know, now I'm really getting mad because I'm the caller. Well, this went on for a while. This went on for about 5, 6 minutes, and it finally stopped. So I went back into my routine and called for about 45 minutes, and nothing happened. And I walked over there, and he said, "How'd you like my call?" I said, I didn't even know you had a call. He said, it sounded good, didn't it? I said, yeah, it sounded real good. He said, it wasn't me. What had happened, on my first series, I called a gray fox in. Now, we had some snow on the ground, and that gray fox came down a deer trail, and they got their legs are shorter, came down that deer trail, and my brother had never seen a gray fox before, so he didn't really know what it was. Plus, it looked, you know, you could just see the top part of it. Well, on the way in, it caught a rabbit about 15 feet from them on the other side of a brush pile, too thick to see. And that was that gray fox killing that rabbit. And I tell you what, it was a lot loud. I mean, I've heard rabbits squeal before all rabbit hunting, but that thing squealed a lot louder and a lot longer than I would have ever imagined, okay? And we went on the other side of the bush, and sure enough, you could see where the fox got the rabbit. There was blood and fur, and it had left straight out, so he never did see it after that. From that day on, I upped my volume, okay? Now, I'm going to give a demonstration on how loud I blow this call. It hurts my ears, and I'm not sure if I can even blow it full volume in here, but I'm not a quiet distress caller. I don't squeak nothing, okay? Sounds like this.
Ah!
loud volume. Turkey hunters know this. If you slam your door loud enough, you can get a turkey to gobble, right? You ever do that? Because it's a reflex action. Coyotes, things happen fast in the world of a coyote. They see a squirrel, they see a rabbit, they hear a rabbit squeal. They got to beyond that thing to, you know, if they want to eat. I think a loud volume like that, just their a reflex action, they just come running right in. So when you do a distress call loud like that, you better be ready, because that coyote could come flying right in. And I would rather have that coyote coming in on instinct, on a reflex action, than coming in using his senses any day. So I always call my distress with a loud volume, always. So, but when you do it, you better be ready, because they can come. I've had them come flying in so fast, it's catches you off guard. But I think most guys call too quiet. Put some volume into it, especially your distress.